What's up, guys? My name's Bran, and by now you've probably already unboxed your brand new 2022 iPhone SE, but now you might be going through the settings, you know, Googling some things, and just kind of wondering what you should do next with your new phone. And that's why I wanted to make this video to show you the first 16 things to do on your new third generation iPhone SE. So this is going to include some settings to change, some features to take advantage of, and just some overall tips and tricks that you might find interesting. And if this video helps you out, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up and also consider subscribing for more iPhone tips and tricks. All right, so the first thing you need to do is understand that you now have 5G. This is the first iPhone SE to get 5G. So make sure you understand it and the best settings for 5G because it is different from LTE. So the first thing you need to know is that we have sub 6 5G. So it's not the top tier 5G like we have on the iPhone 13s. They have millimeter wave 5G. We only have sub 6. Well, that's still better than LTE. It's just not the best of the best when it comes to 5G. So that's one thing to understand. Also, if you go into your settings and go to cellular and then go to cellular data options and then voice and data, you will see a new toggle in here for turning 5G on or 5G auto. I would highly recommend keeping that on 5G auto. And the reason being is because if you have 5G on all the time, it's going to drain your battery. It's only going to connect you to 5G, even if that signal is weak. So I would highly recommend keeping this on 5G auto. And if we go back to data mode right here, I would also recommend keeping this on standard or low data mode. So you could read down here what the allow more data on 5G option is, but 99% of you will not need to enable that really at any time. But I will say that low data mode is very useful if you're running low on battery or if you're concerned about your battery life, I would consider putting your phone in low data mode. You can see here it says it helps reduce cellular data usage by pausing automatic updates and background tasks. And then also in this section is limit IP address tracking, which I would also highly recommend, although that has nothing to do with 5G. I just wanted to point that out to keep that enabled. Now, the next thing you guys need to do is understand the home button on the iPhone SE. So some of you are gonna come from mechanical home buttons like the iPhone 7 and earlier. So if you had an iPhone SE, iPhone 6S, iPhone 7, you guys had a mechanical home button. Well, this is not a mechanical home button. It's actually software based. So if you push down, it feels like you're pushing a physical button, but you're not. It's actually based on software, just like what the iPhone 8 had. And if you go into your settings and go to general and then to home button, you have the option here to change the haptic. And you probably already did this in the setup process, but if you wanted to go back and change it, you could go in here and change the home button haptic and basically how it feels when you press it. I think too, the default is the best, but you can play around with that here in settings. But I did also just want to point out that it's a haptic home button, not a mechanical home button, which means that it technically cannot break because it's not mechanical. And no matter how many times you press it, it will not break. Now, the next thing you guys need to do is set up your Touch ID and passcode if you did not do so in the initial setup process. There's also some things in here that I would recommend changing. So first off, I would recommend adding at least two fingerprints right here. So when you go down to fingerprints, add a second fingerprint, either that's for another finger or your other hand, or if you have, you know, like a kid or a significant other that you want to allow into your phone, have them add their fingerprint right there as well. Also, one thing that I change in here is password autofill. I turn that off so I don't have to use Touch ID every single time I want to enter a password in Safari. That gets pretty annoying. That is personal preference, but I personally like turning that one off, and all the other ones I like keeping on. Also, if we go down to the allow access when locked section, you may want to consider turning some of these off so you have more privacy, so people can't just go into your phone and search for things or reply to messages from your lock screen. So this is where you change that right there. The next thing you should do with your iPhone SE is test out that camera and the brand new photographic styles. So you'll see this pop up the first time you open up the camera, and I'll show you how to do that in a minute. But the first thing you guys should do is just test out this camera because it is definitely greatly improved from the previous generation iPhone SE. So that's thanks to the A15 Bionic chip inside, and that gives you Smart HDR4 and Deep Fusion, which are both post-image processing features that just make your photos look so much better. Those are the features that the iPhone 13 and 13 Pro have. So try out that camera and you'll be surprised at how good photos turn out from such a tiny little camera on the back of this phone. And now let's talk about those photographic styles. So if you swipe up in the camera app, you get these quick controls right there. If you tap on this, that will take you to the photographic styles. And what these are is they're essentially glorified Instagram filters just built into your camera application. But keep in mind, once you take a photo with that filter, you cannot change it. So if we go over here, you have standard, you have rich contrast, you have vibrant, you have warm, and you have cool. Now, the cool thing about this is you can customize these to your liking. So if you don't like the preset, you could change it to whatever you like. And then once you are set on one, so let me go ahead to vibrant right here and customize it a little bit. There we go. Now it's set. And if I take a picture, it's going to take it with that filter on, and you cannot change it afterwards. And if you take a look up in the top right, it will indicate when you have a photographic style enabled. So if you tap on that, it will show you which one you have right there. And you could also get to this in settings. So if you go into your settings and then down to camera and then just scroll down to photographic styles, you could select them right here. You also get additional details in here as well. I also wanted to mention this toggle right here that says show detected text. That is live text. So you want to make sure that's turned on, unless you find this annoying, which I don't. I think it's a really cool feature. But if you hold your phone in front of some text, you will actually be able to copy that text right there. You don't even need to take the picture. If you just go ahead over, you see it says iPhone, just tap this little icon down there in the bottom right, and you will be able to copy, select all, or look up straight from here. You don't even need to take a photo of it. Of course, you can if you want to, but you don't need to. And if I were to take a photo of something and then go back into my photos application right here, I could also do the same thing. I can copy the text from that photo, which is really cool. The next tip is to take advantage of voice control for a fully hands-free experience. So the iPhone SE is small, so you know you're probably going to be able to use this at all times. But if you don't have a free hand, you can enable voice control and actually talk to your phone and tell it to do exactly what you want. So if you go into your settings here, we're going to go to our accessibility settings. And then if we scroll down to voice control right here, you want to turn this on, and it will have to download some files, and it will be turned on right after that. And then if we go out of that settings page, you can see right here, we will get some numbers on our screen, and we could just basically talk to our phone and tell it what to do. So watch this. Press 20. Press 16. Scroll down. Press 11. Scroll down. Go home. Press 3. Press 2. And just like that, we were able to control our phone just from our voice and nothing else. So you could also enable this via Siri. So if I go ahead down here to Siri, turn on voice control, you can see it will turn it on just like that. And speaking of Siri, you may want to change the Siri voice. And we actually have a brand new one with iOS 15.4, which actually comes pre-installed with the iPhone SE. So if you go into Siri and search right here, and then go to Siri voice, you now have 5 different options to choose for your Siri voice. So the Voice 5 is a brand new one, so you may want to listen to that and change it if you would like to. Now, the next thing you guys should do after getting your new iPhone SE is to set up your display settings. So if we go into our settings here and go to accessibility and then to display and text size, and then go all the way down to the bottom, we have things like auto brightness. So I've had a lot of mixed opinions on auto brightness over the past few years, but it's gotten a lot better recently and something I use every day on my main phone. So that is something you might want to consider. Also, if you cannot see as well, you could turn on bold text. You could also turn on larger text right here and other things like button shapes and on-off labels, and also reduce transparency. Now, if we go back into our settings and go to the display and brightness section, we also have our light and dark mode. And I like turning this on automatic, so it goes into dark mode when the sun sets. I am recording a video though, so it looks better in light mode. So we do also have true tone right here. You could turn that off or on. So it just depends on your style. I personally like turning it on, but if you turn it off, you can see you get a much more blue screen. So it just depends on what you prefer with the tone of your phone. We also have night shift and auto lock. I like turning this on 5 minutes. That is just when your phone locks after not touching it or interacting with it. If you turn it on never, sometimes you could just forget or go to sleep with your phone on and it will drain all your battery. So that's why I like turning it on to 5 minutes. Also, race to wake is a feature I just do not like. I think it wastes a lot of battery and it's just unnecessary. But if you like that, you could turn that on. I personally keep that off. We also have the display zoom right here. Since we do have a small phone, you may want to consider putting this on zoomed so you could see things better, since this is, again, such a small display. And then also we do have our text size and bold text right there as well. You should also go ahead and customize your home screen and your control center. So your home screen right here is very easy to customize now. Of course, we can move multiple icons at once. If we just tap and hold on one and then use our other finger to tap the other icons, you can see you can move multiple applications at once very easily. Also, now if you tap and hold, and if you're in the jiggle mode right here, and if you tap on the page dots down there, you could hide entire pages. So if you just tap on the check mark there, you can hide an entire page. You could also remove an entire page, or you could just move them around. So if you want this to be your first page, you can now move that and it will be your first page on your springboard. So you can do a lot of customization with your home screens on the iPhone SE here in iOS 15. And if you tap on the little plus icon there up in the top right, that is how you get to the widgets. So if you tap on that, it will take you to widgets right here. I would recommend putting on some widgets because they are awesome and they don't drain battery life like they did in the past. So you can go ahead and add those here. You usually get multiple different styles of the widget, different, you know, sizes, as you can see here. And then customizing the control center is also something I would highly recommend doing. So if you go into your settings here and then go down to control center and then to show home controls, I like turning that off on the iPhone SE. I have a lot of HomePod minis and HomePods in my house, so I do love having that in my control center. However, the iPhone SE is a small device and that is just taking up a ton of space. I like the toggles a lot more than I like seeing my home controls. So that is something I would consider turning off. Depends on how much you use your home controls. But down here is where you add in your different control center toggles that you would like. I do like music recognition. Let me go ahead and add that one in there. And I pretty much have every one I want in there right now. So this is uneven. I don't like having to scroll in my control center. So I'm going to take one of these out, one that I don't use that much. I don't use stopwatch really at all. So there we go. I can now screen record. I can turn on my low power mode. I have my flashlight there, all kinds of things I could do from the control center. Of course, you can always move these around if you want to as well. And speaking of customizing, the iPhone SE also comes with exclusive wallpapers that are only available on the iPhone SE. So if you go into your settings here, and if we go down to wallpaper and then choose new wallpaper and then to stills and go all the way down to the bottom, you can see we have three exclusive wallpapers, again, only found on the new iPhone SE 3. So we have this one right here, which is meant for my color, the starlight. You have this one right here, and then you have this one right here, which I believe this one is meant for the midnight, this one for the product red. But you have all those that you could choose, and they look much better than the default wallpaper that comes with your SE. And if you want to take it one step further, you could also set up an automation so your wallpaper changes every single morning. And if you want to find out how to do that, I will leave that linked in the card up above and also down in the description below. The next thing you guys might want to do is add the battery percentage to your status bar. So I don't know how this is not enabled by default, but it's not. But if you go to your settings here and then to battery, you should turn on battery percentage right here. That is definitely something you should do right away because it's always good to see what your battery life is and not have to guess. Also, if we go down to battery health, you want to make sure your maximum capacity is at 100%. If it's not, I would take that back to the Apple Store ASAP and get a new one. Also, I would recommend keeping on optimized battery charging so it trickle charges after 80%. And if you find your battery life to be poor on the iPhone SE 3, make sure to watch my battery saving tips video. That's going to go through a ton of different settings that you might want to disable that could be eating away at your battery life on your SE. So if you want to watch that video, I will leave that linked down in the description below. The next thing you guys need to do is to customize your notifications and your notification settings. So notifications are one of the number one killers of battery life. I see it all the time. So many people get way too many notifications that they just simply don't need. So if you go to your notifications here, I would go ahead in each application and select what you want. If you want notifications from those applications or not. Or an easier way to do this now in iOS 15 is through a focus mode. So if you go into focus right here, I'm currently in my recording a video focus mode, so I will not get any type of notification except for from certain people that you see right here. So if you go down here to applications, you can add applications that you would like to see notifications from, and anything that's not in here, you will not receive any notifications from. So I would highly recommend going into your focus modes right here and customizing one to your liking. That way you can always turn it on or off from the control center right here, and you will not get as many notifications. Or if you don't do that at all, just go into your notification settings right here and just turn off notifications for the apps that just simply do not need notifications, like Call of Duty. Why would I need notifications for a game and things like that? You know what I mean? Just customize your notifications so you're not getting a ton of them throughout the day. The next thing you guys need to do after getting your iPhone SE is to set up emergency SOS and emergency contacts. So if you go into your settings here and then go down to emergency SOS, you will see that we now have an option to call with hold. So this is also new in iOS 15.4, and it says if you press and hold the side button right here, and volume buttons together, the emergency SOS slider appears. If you continue to hold them, a countdown begins and an alert sounds. When the countdown ends, iPhone calls emergency services. So if you want to call emergency services quickly, all you have to do is hold all three of these at the same time and it will call. Of course, you can also do the five presses right here. So if you tap this five times rapidly, it will call, but that is disabled by default. So if you want to re-enable that, if that's the way you prefer, you can turn that on and turn off call withhold. I would also add at least one emergency contact right here. That way somebody else is notified if you are in danger or if you got hurt or something like that. Now, the next thing you need to know is that your iPhone SE is able to be fast charged. So you could charge up to 50% in 30 minutes, but only if you're using a 20 watt adapter. So by now, most of you should have a 20 watt adapter. If not, I would go out and buy one for $19. It's going to charge your phone much faster than one of those old blocks that you had back in the day. I'm sure you guys saw this one coming, but the next thing you need to do is to consider getting a case for your iPhone SE and a screen protector. So one of the two, if not both. So these are the Apple silicone cases right here, which are nice. They don't offer the best drop protection, so you can look at alternatives for better drop protection, but I would consider at least a screen protector. If you're not gonna get a case, at least get a screen protector, although the back is glass, so you probably want a case as well. I would just protect that investment with both. Again, it may not look the best, but you're not really buying a phone for the look. You're buying it more for that functionality and protecting that investment, especially if you don't have AppleCare. And then finally, if you bought a 64 gigabyte iPhone SE, you should buy more iCloud storage. And better off, you know, if you're still within the return period of your iPhone, I would just return it and pay $50 additional to double your storage to 128. But if you can't afford it, I understand, but you're just gonna need to buy more iCloud storage and that's gonna add up to $50 in no time. So low storage is the number one cause of battery drain and slow performance. So even if you got 128, I would recommend getting above the default iCloud storage. You need a lot more than 5 gigabytes. So if you go to your iCloud and then go to manage storage right here, and then go to change storage plan, this is where you'll be able to have different downgrade or upgrade options. So I have the 2 terabyte plan, which is overkill for 99% of people, but I would recommend at least upgrading from the free iCloud storage. That way you're able to actually store more things on the cloud and not have them be on your device and bogging it down and draining your battery life. So consider buying more iCloud storage. It is definitely worth it. Oh, and if you do buy more iCloud storage, make sure you turn iCloud backup on. That way, if something happens to your phone, you're still able to retain all of your information. You will not lose it. So there you have it, guys. Those are the first 16 things that you should do after getting your brand new iPhone SE third generation. Of course, there are more out there, and I may even make another video on tips and tricks for the iPhone SE. If you would like to see that, let me know in a comment down below. But nonetheless, I hope this video did help you out at least a little bit. If it did, I would really appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up. Also, please consider subscribing. If this video helped you out, I will be making a lot more iPhone tips and tricks videos in the future, and I do these type of videos every time a new Apple product drops. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.